Hi guys, how are you? I hope you are alright. This is a class for first year A, B and C. So first year, Lenguas Vivas, language 1. Today we are going to start with unit number 2, connected with the verb tenses that you are going to come across in this unit. And we are going to deal with narrative verb tenses. What is narrative verb tenses? Narrative verb tenses are used to tell stories. And well, this is a summary of the different narrative verb tenses that you will see. The simple past, you remember, used for finished action. Also, it is used as a subjunctive when we talk in the second case of conditional sentences. The past continuous is used for overlapping actions. That is to say, two actions in progress in the past. One in progress and the other, of course, interrupted by another one. Past perfect is an action finished before another action in the past, or it can also be used for unreal past, that is to say subjunctive in the third type of conditional sentence. The past perfect continuous, something that started in the past and continued up until another time in the past, or it is also used for cause-effect in the past. And the future in the past can be expressed with was or were going to or would, something which was from the perspective of future in the past. Now, let's deal with the grammar structures of the different verb tenses. Simple past, remember, subject plus the verb in the past. The past continuous, was or were plus the gerund, that is to say the ing form. Or past perfect with have plus the past participle, or past perfect continuous had been plus the gerund, that is to say the ing form, or the future in the past, we can use would plus infinitive, or was or were going to plus infinitive. These are the narrative verb tenses. Now, let's deal with the past perfect continuous. Why? I am going to focus on the past perfect continuous because maybe some of you did not study this verb tense, but it's very simple. It is used, one of the main uses of the past perfect continuous is to express a cause-effect relation in the past. For example, I was tired. Why were you tired? Because I had been working all day long. So, with the past perfect continuous, you are showing the effect of the first action. I was tired because I had been working all day long. Or John and Peter were dirty because they had been playing football. The past perfect continuous can also be used to show how long to a point in the past. For example, she had been working at the company for a year when she met her husband. So, how long to a point, which point, when she met her husband, she had been working at the company for a year. So, these are the main uses of the past perfect continuous. So, I wrote here an example using the different narrative tenses. When I was walking around San Martin Park yesterday, I met my friend Pedro. He told me he was desperate because his son had left home 2 weeks before. He looked exhausted because he had been looking for him for the past 2 weeks. He also told me he was going to hire a private detective because the police hadn't found him. Past continuous, past simple, past simple, past perfect continuous, past simple, future in the past and past perfect. Okay, they are all the verb tenses that we are going to use in a narrative story. So this is the example, that I included here. The example is, I have plans for last Saturday night. I eat out. Well, in between brackets, you've got the verbs. So, I, in the past. I had plans for last Saturday night. I was going to eat out with my friends, but I couldn't go anywhere because when I was about to leave, I realized I had lost my wallet. So, past simple, past continuous, past simple, past perfect. This is an example of how you are going to use the narrative verb tenses in the different activities. Now I switch to Spanish. Finally, me voy a dar decir esto en español. Nosotros con la profesora Tintilay estamos subiendo las actividades a Edmodo. Ella en su clase, yo en mi clase. Tengan paciencia, vamos subiendo las unidades. Después de subir las unidades, yo les voy a subir las keys, es decir, las claves de corrección también, y estos videos ilustrativos para que ustedes puedan ir entendiendo y haciendo esas actividades. Ya comenzamos con la unidad número 2. Okay, that's all. Thank you. See you.